like, if you don't start to open up more, I'm going to start feeling like I'm talking to myself. All right, no need to get upset. I was only joking. Oh well, I guess it was worth a try. Hey, we're still on for Chess Tuesday, right? Okay, good. I'll see you then. Bye, friend.
Hello, Frank. Don't tell me you forgot about our meeting.
No, it's not that. Thought we were meeting Tuesdays. Wasn't expecting you so soon.
Frank, today is Tuesday.
Oh.
So, how are things back in civilization, Frank? Are you sleeping much?
No.
Anything you want to talk about?
Not really.
Okay. How about work, Frank? Been looking for a job?
Yeah. I got a few leads. Nothing really concrete, though. Landlord came around again.
What did he want?
Money. That's all he ever wants is money. It's your move.
Why are you pouring that out?
There's a leak in the ceiling. I don't want it to overflow.
But the pot was only half full. You could have let it be for at least another couple of days and emptied it then. Why now, when there's no need? Are you listening, Frank?
Yeah, so what? Isn't it better to be empty?
How do you mean?
If I don't do it now, I might forget to do it later. The bowl can only hold so much. You ever think about water, Ray?
In what sense?
In all senses. It's a life force, you know? After all, we're made of water. Civilizations throughout history have used it to represent the essence of life itself. Hell, as a species, we're born of the sea. We're defined by the land, yet we're born of the sea. Formless at first, and gradually caged by our bodies.
In the Judeo-Christian sense, water is the purifier, the cleanser of the spirit.
There is no purity in form. Water is the purifier only in the sense that it's shapeless in nature. Anything readily susceptible to touch is readily susceptible to corruption and corrosion. As soon as we're born, we begin to rot. It's only once the stench of our own decay begins to affect others that anybody notices or even cares at all.
You believe that true purity is formless, but one cannot exist without form. Without body. To exist in the present is to exist tangibly. If you believe that physical existence is impure, then do you believe that human existence is impure?
Jippy test, say hi.
Just a minute!
Thank you.
Hello, Frank.
Come on, what's the matter? Surprised to see me, Frank?
I know you're dead.
Do you, Frank? And how do you know that? How can you really be sure? After all, it was just a dream, wasn't it, Frank?
What else could it be?
I'm here now, aren't I? If it was all a dream, and I'm here now, how can you be sure the dream's really over? What defines the reality in which you live, Frank, by what you're able to see and touch? If you no longer separate fact from fiction, who's to say there is, ever was a difference?
Stop. Just stop. You're supposed to be kind. You're supposed to be compassionate. For Pete's sakes, you're my friend, Ray.
Who are you to tell me what I am or who I'm not? Up until now, you thought I was dead. But how do you know that you aren't either?
What you're saying is preposterous. You're dead. Or I'm dreaming. Or is this hell?
Hell? You believe in God now, Frank? I never took you for the religious type.
I'm not. There's nothing more idiotic than the dogmatic worship of a hidden master.
So you dogmatically worship the absence of a higher power. The only thing worse than a religious fanatic is an atheist, Frank. Better to worship something than to worship nothing.
What does that make you? You despise the religious because they put themselves above the rest of us. Yet you despise the godless because they put themselves above the religious. Yet you put yourself above both. What does that make you?
Come now, Frank. This isn't about me. This is about you. You can't teach a grand to suck eggs, so don't bother trying.
This can't be real. I refuse to believe so.
Real? Aren't you listening, Frank? Real is a single-sided term. There exist infinite versions of everything. You always were a bird's ass, Frank. Always too afraid to commit to decisions. Too afraid to just pick one.
Just shut up, please.
You ever leave a kettle on the stove and then forget about it, Frank? Gets hotter and hotter till it screams. They say a watched pot never boils, but a forgotten kettle screams until there's nothing left inside.
We know each other. Why are you doing this to me?
Because I can. You think you need a reason? There is no reason. Reason implies an agenda. Would it satisfy you if you knew I had some sort of higher agenda? I'm no God. I'm no devil. I simply am. Reason only serves to excuse action regardless of intention. I need no motivation to act in one way or another. That I can act in any way at all is motivation enough. Things just happen, Frank. I am doing this to you simply because I can. That should be reason enough.
No!
Frank!